Hey guys, what's going on? So today I want to talk a little bit about note-taking. Note-taking for me has changed a lot in the past couple months. My work style and the things that I've been wanting to do lately have really changed, and I really needed to refocus my efforts. I've talked a lot in the past about how I use Apple Notes with the Apple Pencil, and that's a great solution. If you use that solution and that works for you, that's fantastic. It worked for me for quite a while. And I think note-taking is something that's really important, to be honest. I think it doesn't matter if you're a CEO of a really large corporation, or if you're just a student, everyone does note-taking. So I kind of delve into the world of note-taking. I took a look at a lot of different stuff, and I think I found a lot of things that were really interesting, and I kind of wanted to share them with you guys. So in this video, I'm going to be covering lots of different apps and services and a few other different practices of note-taking. Hopefully, you guys can kind of take something away and kind of either improve or find something completely new for you. For me, personally, I started off with two major things. I wanted to have an area where I wanted something that I could write my scripts and my outlines and blog posts and all that stuff in one particular area. I wanted to be able to just write all that stuff down, and it needed to have markdown support. That was very important to me. And I also wanted something that I could just quickly get into and just write my thoughts. If I had something that popped in my brain, whether it was a video or a project idea, just something about life in general, I just wanted to be able to write it down as quickly as possible. So I kind of took a look at three different categories. There's digital note-taking, there's handwritten notes, and then I also took a look at the handwritten digital combo notes, kind of like what I've been doing with the Apple Pencil and Apple Notes already. So let's jump into it. First, let's talk about digital note-taking. And when I mean digital, I mean typed notes. You sit down with a text document and you type. This is pretty straightforward, this is pretty simple, and I think most of you guys that are watching, this is probably what you want. And this can really be any app. It doesn't have to be any particular app, but I'm gonna cover a few of the ones that I found through my research. So first up, the one that I probably talk the most about is Apple Notes, and I'm just gonna briefly cover it, because I do think Apple Notes, since it's got a redesign in iOS 9, it's a fantastic application. Apple Notes is probably the best option for anybody that just wants to get into note-taking. If you don't have any specific needs or something that you absolutely can think of that you have to have off the top of your head, Apple Notes is probably the best. It has, it's free, first of all, because it comes straight from Apple. It has good sync. It has folder support, so you can organize things. You can pin things. It has keyboard shortcuts for formatting. It has Apple Pencil support, which I'll talk about a little bit more a little later, but I think overall it's a fantastic application. It's a good app if you're delving into note-taking. This is a good place to start off from. I did a really in-depth video on the Apple Notes redesign, so I'll put that in the description below, along with links to all the apps and all the videos and stuff that I mentioned in this thing. They'll be in the description. Notebooks is a really interesting application. What I think is really cool about notebooks is you actually put notebooks inside the apps, and they look like physical notebooks, so they get really cool cover art, and you can label them, so you can label them by projects or classes or meetings or even a date. It's kind of a really cool setup, and I like that sort of organization. It's a really fantastic app. It fell short in a couple of places. It doesn't really have markdown support, so that's why for me, it just doesn't work, but I do like the idea of the organization. So if you work on a lot of big projects or something like that, this would be really handy app to go into. Inside the notebooks, you can create blank pages, so you can type things, you can create tasks lists, you can dictate to it, you can even attach photos or files. So that's something that's really cool that I think is pretty handy to do with this kind of app. I'm reluctant to even mention this next one, and I really debated whether to include it or not because I don't like the application, but it's Evernote. I find the app to be really, really clunky, but what Evernote has been good at and has always been good at, and then, to be honest, it was one of the first apps I ever used for note-taking. I used it way back when I was still in high school. It's been an app that I've used forever, but what's great about Evernote is it's really good at organization. It's good at taking large amounts of notes or text or files or whatever, and you can organize them, you can tag them, you can put them in folders, pretty much any way that you want to organize them, it's there. So if you have a large amount of notes, this might be a good solution to look at. I'm not a super fan of their app, but I know there's a lot of people that still really like it. Back in the day, I absolutely loved it. You couldn't pry it away from me, but unfortunately now, I just feel the app is a little too clunky for me. When I was a full-time Mac user, I used an app called NVAlt, and it was my note-taking app. Basically, it was just looked at a folder of text documents, and you could create and edit from there. And when I moved to the iPad, I wanted something that could do the same thing. And I found an app called OneWriter. And OneWriter is an absolutely fantastic application because what it does is it just looks at a folder in Dropbox and it brings all those text files in. So you can either create, edit, or just read text files from it. Now, a lot of people are probably like, well, that seems like a lot of work. Why can't it just sync with iCloud, blah, blah, blah. But what's great about this kind of setup is you own your data. If an app or a service was to shut down tomorrow, you would lose that data. Now, most of the time when an app or service does shut down, they give you a certain amount of time to get all your data out and stuff like that. But it has happened before. Stuff is just shut down. It stopped working. It goes down. But what's great about this is it's text files, and you have the text files. So if OneWriter was to stop being supported, you could just move to another app that did a very similar thing. And there are quite a few apps that do this. I just found OneWriter to be the best. It has Markdown support. And if you're not sure what Markdown or Task Paper is, I'm going to be doing a video on that a little later. Coming soon, I promise. Explaining that, because I know I've talked about it a lot, but I don't think I've ever really gone into what it is for those that don't know. But if you're interested in keeping your own documents, keeping everything in text documents kind of separate, check out OneWriter. OneWriter is a great app. Even if you're just doing like long form stuff, OneWriter can be good for that as well. So I alluded to it earlier that I switched away from Apple Notes. So what did I switch to? Well, a few of you that have been watching my video since the beginning might remember a video I did about an app called Bear. Bear is a note-taking app that's absolutely great. It's beautifully designed, it has amazing features, and I absolutely love it. What's great is it has iCloud sync, so it syncs between all my devices. And like I already mentioned, it has Markdown, which is important to me. It has drag and drop. So if you start dragging a note, there's an action bar at the bottom and you can drop that note on there and you can get a list of actions. So you can do things like pin things to the top, which is really handy for when I'm working on lots of different videos. I want to keep those at the top. Or you can get like the notes identification number. So if you're doing some sort of automation, you can hook that into it so you can automate individual notes, which is kind of cool. I think this app does a lot. I think there's a lot of room for it to grow, but for what I need, something that syncs, something that has Markdown, something that, you know, has the right features for me, I think Bear is the application for me. And it works great for my outlines and my scripts and bigger things like that. But I also alluded to it earlier that I wanted something that I could just quickly, you know, get my thoughts out of my head. And that was really important to me. And for that, I actually switched to an analog option. I tried a lot of different options. I tried workflows, I tried apps, I tried launchers, all sorts of things. But it just wasn't the apps or the services or anything that was holding me back. It was the fact that it was digital. I just needed to be able to quickly write down some thoughts. So I grabbed a pen and a notepad and I started writing. I did this for a couple of weeks and it really, really worked well for me personally. Now, this isn't going to be something that works for everybody, and I know a lot of people probably want to have, it's more important for them to have their notes everywhere with them, and I completely understand that. So for me, I really just tried, you know, writing stuff down. So what I would do is I'd grab a notepad and I'd write the date at the top, and I'd write everything that went on during that day. So any thoughts or ideas or anything that happened, I'd write that down, and that would be, you know, kind of just my way of getting all the stuff out of my head for the day. And this worked really, really well for me. And then I started, you know, moving more and more. So I started, you know, every project, I started writing, you know, basic ideas down for it on one page, and then I'd flip it over and then I'd write, you know, editing notes and stuff on the other page and stuff like that. And that was really handy. And it helped me to remember ideas and stuff that I had that I wasn't able to execute at that particular time. And they didn't just get lost in the ether. So that was really important to me. Once I knew this was a solution that I personally really liked, I moved up and I started using fancy paper and pen. And this is something that I don't necessarily recommend for everybody unless, you know, this is going to be a solution that you really want to use that really works for you. But if you do really like using pen and paper, definitely check out getting a good pen and a good paper. It makes the whole experience a little more enjoyable. So my last point is, if you find digital note-taking to be a distraction, whether it's notifications or you just kind of want to play around on the internet or whatever, try a pen and paper. It's really, really good feeling, and I really just enjoy it. It's kind of hard to explain unless you try it. I know I probably sound like a lunatic, but just give it a shot. It really is fantastic. So the last category I wanted to cover was the kind of Apple Pencil digital combo, you know, handwritten notes, but digitally. And I think this is an important area to cover. I personally was doing this for a while, and like I talked about, it just doesn't fit right for me anymore. I needed a little bit more. And that's kind of where Bear came in, so I could be a little more organized with my scripts and outlines and handwriting notes just to kind of be a little bit quicker and a little bit better about writing everything down. I didn't always have my iPad Pro and I didn't always have my Apple Pencil with me, so I couldn't always just quickly jot things down. If you are interested in handwriting notes digitally, it is a great solution. And I recommend checking out a couple of apps, Notability and GoodNotes. I did a really in-depth video in Notability already. Like I said, I'll link it in the description below. Apple Notes is also a good solution. And Notebooks, another app that I mentioned previously, also has the ability to handwrite with the Apple Pencil. I just don't think it's as robust as Notability or GoodNotes is. Those two apps, they're Apple Notes Plus. They have so many great features in them. It's definitely worth checking out. If you're a student or somebody, what's great about Notability is you can record audio. So if you record, you can record lectures while taking notes and things like that so you can reference back. It's a pretty handy app to have. Before I wrap up, I wanted to start doing something a little more in my videos. I want to start talking more about automation. But instead of making videos specifically about automation and workflow and things like that, I want to start sprinkling it into my other videos so I can talk about how, in this particular instance, how note-taking can be automated. For me, what I did is I created a workflow that would quickly launch Bear into a new note so I can edit that and just start typing right away. What was great about that is it would skip the launch screen, it would skip all me seeing all the scripts and stuff that I had queued up that I needed to work on, and it would just launch that, it would start typing, and I'd be good to go. It was a fantastic way of doing things. I definitely recommend, if you don't use Bear, there's lots of other notes apps in workflow that you can work with. So I definitely recommend automating your notes app. Just automate it so that it creates a new note and that you could start typing right in there. It's something that I found that can be really handy and a little bit quicker. I'm not saying that my particular style is the end-all be-all. In fact, it'll probably keep evolving. And that's the thing about my videos, is I want to show how my work and your work and everybody's work can keep evolving when new tech and new apps and new services come around. Now, obviously, pen and paper is not new. It's just something that, you know, I'm supposed to be the iPad guy. I'm supposed to do everything digitally. So I never really gave that an honest try. So it's something that in these videos, I just want to show that your work should be evolving to make yourself more productive, quicker, better at what you do. I want to hear what you guys are using. So if you have a particular service or app or something that you guys have been using, let me know in the comments below. I really do want to try out more stuff. I'm sure I missed a bunch of stuff. So let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like what I'm doing here, like and subscribe. It does really help out the channel. Have an awesome day.